Now simply head to the image processing tab, and in here you can find multiple options to filters and effects. First off, let's talk about the auto deskew option. So the auto deskew option allows you to rotate slightly inclined pages, such as this one. Click auto deskew and it applies the rotation. Next, let's talk about the despeckle option. Now the despeckle option allows you to remove slight imperfections in the image. As you can see, there are black spots that I do not want on this image. Click despeckle. And as you can see, these black spots have been removed. Now, as you may have noticed, I had a pop-up message here. This allows you to apply a specific effect in batch. Whenever you get this pop-up message, you'll be able to apply that that effect or that filter on all pages, all of your pages. Now, if you click yes, it will apply it to all pages. If you click no, it will apply it to none of the pages. And if you tick this box, it will remember your choice to not ask you again. This pop-up message can be found in the settings if you want to disable it or re-enable it. Next up, let's talk about remove margins. Now, you can choose to remove any margins, erase black borders, crop back borders, crop white borders, and auto crop current borders. I will decide to crop black borders on this page. And as you can see, if I tick this box here, it will no longer pop up. And as you can see, this page is much preferable than the page I had before. You also have an option to remove punch holes if you do have punch holes on your page. You can also choose to apply the negative effect to your page. For the negative effect, we will do this for a page that we've imported at the bottom. Simply click negative to apply the negative effect to your page. You click it again to reverse the process. You also have an option for color adjustment to adjust the brightness, contrast, saturation, and gamma levels of your image. You also have an option to convert to black and white using different compression methods. You can choose adaptive, Burke, Floyd Steinberg, Auto Dither, and Stucky. We're going to apply this to this page using the adaptive method. And as you can see, it converted it to black and white. You also have an option to convert to grayscale and an option to convert to color using 24-bit and 8-bit. Next, you have the filters. For the filters, you have three different options you can choose from, being smooth, contrast, stretch, and median. Now, we're going to test this on this image here. If you want to use the median effect, simply click median. And as you can see, this result here is much preferable than the result we obtained before. Next, you also have an option to black and white filters. Delete characters, erode characters, remove isolated dots, remove all lines, and all of these options here. If I want to remove all lines, for instance, as you can see, this has been removed. This is very useful as it allows you to get better results from OCR. Lastly, you have the effects, and in the effects, you can choose any of these options here. Now, we're going to choose Gaussian blur, as shown here. And let's say we want to work on an image, on this image again. You can blur this image, but however, let's say we want to blur only a specific area. You can go back to edit, choose the area selection mode, choose this area here, go back to image processing, effects, and in Gaussian blur, adjust your blurriness. And when this is finished loading, simply click apply. And as you can see, this part of my page has been blurred to hide the price, of course, if that's something you do need to use on your page.